You know, the economy is about to implode. I mean, that much is pretty sure.
We've heard of Bitcoin. We've heard of Ethereum. You familiar with XRP and the efforts of Ripple?
I didn't have any idea that Ripple was going to become the kind of thing that it has become here.
They understand that this is a once-in-a-generation opportunity.
Ripple and XRP are going to be the global standard.
A single global payment network that connects literally everyone.
It's here.
This year.
It's here. It is here already.
Yeah, I see.
It's my belief, based off of all the fundamentals that I've been seeing the past few years, is that we are well positioned and a lot further ahead than most people realize.
300 plus customers.
Using ODL for me as a customer has been game changer.
On-demand liquidity is a feature offered within RippleNet that helps customers eliminate the need to pre-fund an account in the destination country where they're sending funds.
There's $27 trillion sitting in these bank-to-bank accounts. They're called Nostra accounts, Vostra accounts.
Bank money!
We're nearing an inflection point.
This may be your last hurrah here to try to get it in on precious metals and cryptocurrencies.
The real crisis is a dollar crisis. All the money the Fed is printing isn't going to have value. It's not going to buy anything. Prices are going to skyrocket. And in fact, this coronavirus is accelerating that process.
We need to go to a global virtual currency.
Cash is trash.
And cryptocurrencies such as Ripple are vying for a spot in the cashless world.
How can I say this another way, people? I've been at this for years. Load up!
XRP. Going to the moon.
At the end of the day, when the music stops, if you're holding dollars or the equivalent, treasuries, muni bonds, corporate bonds, I don't care if your money is in the bank or under your mattress, you're getting wiped out.
Once this breaks out, we're going to hit 21, 26, 51, and then it's off to the fucking races forever, folks.
I knew you were trouble when you walked in. So shame on me now. We'll be two places I've never been. Now I'm lying on the cold, hard ground. Trouble.
What's good, YouTube? This is RPU here, and I'm back again with another video, bringing you some of the latest news concerning XRP, man. Shout out to Financial Feeds, man. Y'all the plug. They got all the latest news on XRP. So this is the headline. Just came out yesterday. Can Coinbase make or break XRP? Congress? XRP rating? And JP Morgan. This is the second article, you know, saying that Coinbase is going to be a major deciding factor when it comes to XRP taking off. Man, we need to relist XRP ASAP. So, according to Coinbase's counsel, XRP has the highest rating amongst 28 cryptos, meaning it is the closest you can get to a security, a 4 out of 5. Wow. As it has been reported, 8 major cryptocurrency firms in the U.S. will be represented as their top executives testify before the U.S., House Financial Services Committee on December 8th. That's in 4 days. The hearing was set up as part of congressional efforts to establish a regulatory framework for digital assets as the ecosystem shows no signs of stopping its growth in size and significance. Well, I guess they said if we can't stop them, we're going to control it. Coinbase leads Crypto Witness Group. The committee will focus on the challenges and benefits of financial innovation and will receive Alicia Haas, the CFO of Coinbase Global, Jeremy Allaire, the CEO of Circle, Sam Bankman-Fried, CEO of FTX Trading, Chad Cascarilla, CEO of Paxos, and Danielle Dixon, CEO of the Stellar Development Foundation. Wow, a lot of big names in the house, man. I wonder if this is going to be live on, like C-SPAN or something. Maybe I could catch it on YouTube. Their testimony will likely be critical for what lawmakers will think of digital assets, their nature, and how to properly regulate the asset class and the firms within the space without hurting innovation. Oh, I think it may be too late for that. You know, with what they passed in that infrastructure bill, that is atrocious. But hey, we got some senators, you know, fighting back, trying to save crypto, which is good. Coinbase plays a leading role. You see that? Coinbase plays a leading role. The cryptocurrency exchange has become the most relevant in the United States. It has already gone public and has been offering guidance to market participants, blockchain companies, financial institutions, lawmakers, and government officials. Wow, so, you know, if we get relisted on Coinbase, you know, it's official. As part of its leadership play, Coinbase founded the Crypto Rating Council in 2019, which was joined by Anchorage, Bittrex, Circle, Cumberland, DRW, Genesis Trading, Grayscale Investments, and Kraken. OKCoin, Radar, and eToro USA joined later. A lot of big names on that crypto council. The goal of the council was to create a system that rates cryptocurrencies on a scale of 1 to 5, with 1 indicating that a cryptocurrency is most likely a security, and 5 meaning it is likely not a security. According to Coinbase, the ratings are not endorsed by any government agency or third party and don't serve as legal advice. Coinbase's council rated XRP as the closest you can get to a security. So far, the CRC has rated 28 cryptocurrencies, including XRP, the digital asset fueling Ripple's blockchain network. Of the 28 digital assets reviewed, XRP has the highest rating, meaning it is the closest to a security, a 4 out of 5. Not even EOS got such a high score. The digital asset developed by Block One was sued by the SEC for having held an unregistered securities offering and settled the case for $24 million, as well as settled a class action for $27.5 million. EOS was ranked 3.75 out of 5. Now, I'm not sure, but I believe that Ripple did not have a securities offering. You know, they didn't have an initial coin offering, as far as I know. But, you know, even if XRP was a security, the only thing EOS had to do was to pay a fine, you know? But it's not about whether it is a security. It's not a security, you know? And that's why Ripple is willing to fight this. According to the CRC, Ethereum is only a 2 out of 5. Gee, I wonder why. Ripple has been using ex-SEC Commissioner Bill Hinman's 2018 analysis on Ether as proof of total confusion amongst the SEC ranks, as the defendants in the SEC lawsuit look to win the case on a summary judgment over the fair notice defense. A few months ago, attorney Jeremy Hogan offered his analysis on how much of a security each of the top cryptos are. On Ethereum, he considered the 2014 pre-sale, there you go, and centralized management structure as problematic. See? Centralized ICO, but Ether is not a security, right? But XRP is the most decentralized blockchain out there and did not have an ICO and is labeled a security, right? The hypocrisy is astounding. Even more so is the change to staking with Ethereum 2.0. JP Morgan puts pressure on Coinbase for XRP. See, JP Morgan wants XRP. JP Morgan wants XRP listed on Coinbase. And JP Morgan usually gets what he wants. A recent report by JP Morgan pointed to Coinbase as a key player in the return of XRP to normality in the United States, and after and if Ripple wins the SEC lawsuit. Coinbase as a key player. Coinbase. Once we get listed on Coinbase, we're going to the moon. We're going to the moon. Yeah. JP Morgan's North America Equity Research found value in XRP for its unique value in the world of finance, with a clear competitive advantage against SWIFT and complementary to stablecoins. See? A clear competitive advantage. Complementary to stablecoins. Mainstream adoption would be at the end of the tunnel. Yes. Yes, mainstream adoption. Yes, and we were here first. If the company is able to win the SEC lawsuit and trading resumes on major cryptocurrency exchanges like Coinbase, XRP is poised for significant adoption. Once again, we have confirmation that once XRP gets listed on Coinbase, we're going to get a massive pump. But yeah, so now that, you know, the SEC is, you know, not doing so good on this case, they're starting to look at other targets to go after and label as securities. And so I think that the SEC is really like grasping at straws, you know, labeling everything security. But here's the topic. Will Ripple's XRP be joined by Cardano and Tron against the SEC? As the doors close on ADA and TRX, we might be seeing Cardano and Tron making efforts to help Ripple in the XRP saga against the SEC. Isn't that cool? All of our favorite coins are teaming up to take on the SEC. That's crazy. The U.S. operation of eToro has decided to delist Cardano, ADA, and Tron TRX, thus disabling access to new positions and staking rewards, while allowing U.S. residents to close existing positions as they see fit. The move has taken many by surprise, but the reason behind it no longer surprises anyone in the digital asset space. These changes are due to business-related considerations in the evolving regulatory environment, the investment platform stated. Will the SEC take action against Cardano, ADA, and Tron TRX? eToro wasn't clear on what it meant about the evolving regulatory environment, but crypto enthusiasts have become accustomed to seeing the Security and Exchange Commission behind such moves as this one. A few months ago, Coinbase said the SEC gave what's called a Wells Notice about its planned Coinbase Lend program. A Wells notice is the official way a regulator tells a company that it intends to sue the company in court. The cryptocurrency quickly canceled the launch of the lending program. See, I have an article from Reuters. It says U.S. market regulator takes aim at Coinbase lending product. This is from September. The U.S. SEC has told Coinbase that it plans to sue the company if it goes ahead with plans to launch a program allowing users to earn interest by lending digital assets, Coinbase said. Wow. We can't win for nothing. The top U.S. market regulator last week told Coinbase it intends to legally charge the company, Coinbase Chief Legal Officer Paul Grewal said, statement on Tuesday, noting that the firm now plans to delay the launch of its Lend product until at least October. Well, we're in December now, and the Coinbase lending program has launched. So it got launched anyway, and you can now use your Bitcoin as collateral and borrow money, you know, if you ever need money. But the minimum amount that you can borrow is $10,000. So you have to have, you know, a pretty nice chunk of Bitcoin to use this product, you know, which is why I think Binance is a way better exchange, because you can borrow as little as $100 on the Binance loan platform, which is amazing, you know. But anyway, they launched their platform and they claim that the SEC told them that they want to sue over their lending program, and they don't even know why. This is from September. Last Wednesday, after months of efforts by Coinbase to engage productively, the SEC gave what's called a Wells Notice about our planned Coinbase Lend program. A Wells Notice is the official way a regulator tells a company that it intends to sue the company in court. As surprised as we were at the SEC's threat to sue without ever telling us why, we want to be transparent with you about the course of events leading up to it. So yeah, they explain, you know, all of that and why, you know, I can leave this link in the description if you want to read this. But the SEC is going after everybody, labeling everybody and everything a security. It's crazy. Nearly all cryptocurrency exchanges, including Coinbase, delisted XRP in the aftermath of the SEC complaint against Ripple on the 22nd of December 2020, right when we were about to blast off. It seemed like, you know, we were just like breaking like 80 cents or something like that, and then we got slapped with the lawsuit. That was crazy. The SEC's regulation by enforcement has been criticized by many within the trading industry, including two of the agency's five commissioners, Hester Pierce and Elad Roisman. The SEC is just on some other shit. While the SEC argues it has provided solid fair notice with prior guidance and 75 lawsuits against cryptocurrency firms, including Telegram and Block One, which is EOS, it is safe to say that many within the space still don't quite understand what makes a digital asset a security. They also shut down Kik. Kik was about to create a token, and they shut that down too. But in July, attorney Jeremy Hogan took a shot at it and analyzed the top cryptocurrencies for their decentralized nature, including Cardano. I want to show you what he said about Cardano. This is what Jeremy Hogan said about Cardano. He said Cardano is basically an alternative to Ethereum, initially released in an ICO, which automatically raises the security alert for the SEC. The SEC is like, security. However, Cardano did something that was legally very smart. Its initial coin offering took place in my old stomping grounds of Japan, which, as you may have heard, is very legally friendly to crypto. Looks like I might be having to go to Japan. Looks like I might have to be going to Japan. I got my passport. About 95% of the ICO was to Japanese nationals, and from there, sales went into the exchanges for sales to Americans. Very smart, Cardano, because the SEC's long arm does not stretch all the way across the Pacific, Mr. Hogan continued, as he added that crypto platforms that facilitate the exchange of the ADA token, a potentially unregistered security, could be sued by the SEC. So, I guess he said, you know, they could sue. I mean, Cardano is on Coinbase. Well, maybe not for long. You know, they might do the same thing they did to XRP. But the SEC has no jurisdiction in Japan. So, I mean, can they still go after them? They're trying to. Look, they're begging Congress to give them more power. CNBC, the SEC needs more power from Congress to fully regulate crypto, Chair Gensler says. They are not giving up. They are labeling anybody and everybody. And a lot of people don't like, you know, what the SEC is doing. Critics fear SEC Gensler is seeking unlimited powers in crypto regulation. He's gone mad with power. But, so look, with Cardano, their ICO is outside of the regulation of the United States. And so, and then they're going after Tron too. I want to show you something about Tron. Look at this. USDC stablecoin goes live on the Tron blockchain. I showed you guys this in my video when I thought that Sony was partnering with Tron, but somebody in my comments was saying that that was fake news. But USDC running on the Tron blockchain was not fake news. Now, if Tron was not legit, do you really think that Circle would be running USDC on the Tron blockchain? Come on, man. I think that maybe the SEC is picking these tokens because they are next in line to receive regulatory clarity. That's what I believe. Maybe they need these blockchains to be, you know, regulated first so we can get the show on the road. Maybe. That's what I'm thinking. Because otherwise, it just doesn't make sense. I mean, why would Circle run USDC on the Tron blockchain? So, yeah. In Hogan's view, Cardano is basically an alternative to Ethereum. It initially launched in ICO, which automatically raises the security alert for the SEC. Security! Nope, security! Yeah. So, however, Cardano did something that was legally very smart. Its initial coin offering took place in my old stomping grounds of Japan, which, as many of you may have heard, is very legally friendly to crypto. About 95% of the ICO was to Japanese nationals, and from there, sales went into exchanges for sales to Americans. Very smart, Cardano, because the SEC's long arm does not stretch all the way across the Pacific. Mr. Hogan continued as he added that crypto platforms that facilitate the exchange of the ADA token, a potentially unregistered security, could be sued by the SEC. I believe it. Far-fetched, perhaps, but also consistent with some statements from Chairman Gensler that the SEC would focus on exchanges and such. He said, not expecting anything to happen, though. Well, they did. They get it. They did go after Coinbase for their lending program, so they're going after everybody. As to the Tron TRX, the Crypto Rating Council considered it the crypto asset most likely to be deemed a security under U.S. law. The CRC was founded by Bittrex, Coinbase, Gemini, Kraken, Anchorage, Circle, and Grayscale Investments, which lends the entity some credibility. Tron might be on the SEC's hit list because of its $70 million initial coin offering in 2017. Although the funds weren't raised in the U.S., the SEC is going after everybody. If they smell a security, they are on your ass, man. Taking from Attorney Hogan's statements, eToro could be the one at risk of a lawsuit for facilitating the exchange of Cardano and Tron. Okay, so if we can't get you, we're going to get your homeboy. It's a dirty game. SEC versus Ripple, Cardano, and Tron. eToro might have been the first to delist ADA and TRX, but it's unlikely to be the last as fear spreads across the industry, the same way it did when the SEC took action against Ripple. Pull your crypto off the exchange. Pull your crypto off the exchange. If you haven't done it yet, pull your crypto off the exchange before trading gets disabled like they did XRP, man. Pull your crypto off the exchange. It's now more important than ever to have cold storage. The United States, despite its regulatory unclarity, remains a leading market for crypto, blockchain, and overall innovation. Cardano and Tron might want to step in before the damage grows. Ripple has been quite invested in winning against the SEC in the XRP lawsuit, even though many would disagree with the strategy. Kevin O'Leary has recently called it a very bad idea. Wow. Chief Executive Brad Garlinghouse and General Counsel Stuart Alderati said many times that Ripple is using the lawsuit as an opportunity to defend the interests of the whole crypto industry. That's why everybody should be behind Ripple. This is not just about Ripple. This is about everybody. You see, the SEC is going after everybody, labeling everything and everybody as a security. We all have to stand up and fight the SEC and their corruption and all their political ties to Ethereum. As the doors close on ADA and TRX, we might be seeing Cardano and Tron making efforts to help Ripple in this saga in donations, technical expertise, and legal counsel. Yeah, let's link up. Let's link up and fight back, man. Power to the people. This guy says, This is simply FUD and speculation. eToro is a Cardano stack pool operator. They own every ADA that are in their trading platform. They just want to avoid paying tax introduced by the infrastructure bill. There is nothing to do with the SEC. Let me know what you think about that in the comments. So yeah, I think that Cardano and Tron may be next in line for regulatory clarity. So, what else we got? We got some price news for XRP. The current price is 90 cents, under a dollar. It's an opportunity. This is from FX Street. It says XRP price on edge of a cliff as Ripple faces imminent collapse. This came out, what, 4 or 5 days ago? XRP price falls below key Ichimoku levels on the weekly chart. Key oscillator divergence may hint at near-term support. The threat of a 34% drop, however, remains likely. Now, I listened to this guy named Mr. Mafler. He talks about XRP price drop. He's been talking about XRP price dropping for so long. You know, it seems like it's actually coming true now, which is a buying opportunity. XRP price followed the rest of the cryptocurrency market lower over the weekend. The U.S. Thanksgiving holiday gave cryptocurrency traders and investors some early Black Friday deals, but downside risks remain. XRP price dropped below weekly Ichimoku cloud, threatening flash crash conditions. XRP price completed the most bearish weekly candlestick close within the Ichimoku system since the week of February 28th, 2020, last week. The candlestick closed below its final Ichimoku support level, the Kijun Sen, at 95 cents. The XRP now has very little support structure remaining and will now rely on the Chiku span and its final hope of support. I hope XRP can hold the line. The saving grace for XRP bulls is where the Chiku span is positioned for an ideal bearish Ichimoku breakout entry to occur. The Chiku span must be below the bodies of the candlesticks and in open space. Open space is a condition where the Chiku span won't intercept the body of any candlesticks horizontally over the next 5 to 10 periods. For the open space condition to be accurate, XRP price would need to close at or below 59 cents. Wow. We might get a drop to 59 cents. That's a great buying opportunity. Some bullish warning signals are flashing, however, and could trigger some covering by short sellers. Currently, XRP price has bounced off the 38.2% Fibonacci retracement at 84 cents to return above the Kijun Sen. Another factor contributing to the bounce is the Chiku span moving above the body of the candlesticks for the first time since August 13th weekly candlestick. There is an almost imperceptible hidden bullish divergence between the candlestick chart and the composite index. Hidden bullish divergence is when an oscillator creates lower lows when the price chart creates higher highs, only valid if the prior trend was up. Hidden bullish divergence is an early indicator that the prior uptrend will continue, so we may go higher. Contributing further to some near-term support is the RSI, holding the oversold levels of 50 and 40 as support. Bulls ultimately need XRP price to close at or above the $1.18 level to establish a clear and renewed bull market. And that's the end of the article. So yeah, XRP is down. It's down. It's below a dollar. This is a buying opportunity. You know, if it drops to 50 cents... If it drops to 50 cents like this thing said, what is that, 59 cents? I may take out a crypto loan. I may take out a crypto loan, man. I don't want to do it, but I'm tapped out. But if the opportunity presents itself, man, might take out a crypto loan. But yeah, look, a lot of great stuff happening. You know, these people are meeting up. Congress is meeting up with Coinbase and all these other big people in the space. You know, they're probably going to be talking about XRP off the record, you know, and we've had multiple confirmations from like the past two or three articles that once XRP gets listed on Coinbase, there's going to be massive adoption. And the SEC is trying to stifle innovation, you know, and supporting Ethereum on the back end. But yeah, this is all the latest news on XRP today. Let me know what you think about this video. This is RPU, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.